Well, good morning, everyone. How you doing today? It's Thursday. It's Thursday. Week's going by so fast, isn't it? But we've been talking all week about lessons that we can learn that maybe we overlook in the Christmas story. This being December, we want to get ready for Christmas. So I just started looking at, I wonder if we could learn more than we have in the past or even thought about in some of the things that happened in the Christmas story. Now, so I'm going to read a paragraph from Luke chapter 2. And then I want us to think about it a little bit. You up for that? Okay. You're familiar with this paragraph. I know you are. Chapter 2 at verse 4 says, "So Joseph went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David." We actually talked about that on Monday of this week, because it was not accident. It was not an accident that Jesus was born in the line of David. It had been predicted from way back by the prophets. Verse 6, though. "While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn." Sometimes we glance over that. Let's think about it from Mary's perspective for a little while. And I think that can be our verse for the day. There was no room for her in the inn, which is verse 7. Now, especially to you moms, but the dads too, when you were having a child, your baby was about to be born, did you give that much thought on where they would be born? Which hospital? What time? It's a rhetorical question, because I know you did. I know you did. We had two children. One was born here at Hoag Hospital in Newport Beach. Why? Well, one, it was close by, and two, we thought it was a great hospital. I still think that today. So Holly was born in Hoag Hospital. Our other daughter, we were now living back in Pennsylvania 4 years later. And, there weren't as many hospitals or what we consider good hospitals. And the other issue that was happening at the time, it's still happening, but we were strong believers that abortion was wrong. And so I actually had done research, and so there was only one hospital in the Lehigh Valley of Pennsylvania that did not do abortions. So being young, we were very idealistic, and we thought we want our baby to be born there. That's the good news, that's how we made our decision. But the fact of the matter is, that hospital with no traffic was 20 minutes away. So we were a little concerned, would labor last long enough? Because I was not up to having the baby on the freeway or something. But I'll bet you did the same. You thought, where is the best place that we can have this child, where the child and you or the mom would be safe and well cared for? Where is that? I know that, don't you know, when you think of it like that, that Mary was concerned. When they couldn't find a room or a clean place, let's say, for her baby to be born, you know it was upsetting to her. It had to be. It had to be. Where? Can you just hear her saying, "Joseph, where can I have this baby? It's coming. He's coming. We've got to find a place." And Joseph, the best he could do, but God did provide a place for her baby to be born. It was the right place. It was awesome. But notice, yes, God provided. But when did he provide? Right at the end. Right at the end. He provided, but it was in his time, not in Mary and Joseph's time, because they would have loved to have that in advance, right? No, he provided it at just the right time. That's the God. Their God is our God. The ones that provided for Mary and Joseph will always provide for you. Take it to him in prayer. He won't let you down. He loves to provide for his children, but it's at just the right time. I thought it would be appropriate if today the song that we would listen to would be Away in a Manger. And both today and every time that we sing it through this holiday season, let's remember the manger was not Mary's first choice, but it was God's choice for her. And a great example of God providing, not in advance, but at just the right time. That's a lesson for you and for me. I always need to learn it. I'm always more in a rush than God is. Have you experienced that? Of course you have. Well, I found a rendition of Away in the Manger that disturbs my heart. I know it's going to bless you. Let's watch it together, and then I'll see you back right here tomorrow. God bless you.
Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the sky looked down where he lay, the little Lord Jesus asleep on. The cat.